Yeah, and Medicaid expansion could be the issue that winds up upending this whole budget process. Governor Hassan wants it, and while she's not yet threatening a veto of the plan if it doesn't have it in there, there are strong convictions over this one that might be hard to budge.
All of us are caretakers of our taxpayers' hard-earned money.
It really came as no surprise that the GOP-held Senate passed its spending plan down party lines 13 to 11, despite loud cries against proposed cuts to social programs.
1,100 homeless children in my city. 1,100 homeless. Those children are the most vulnerable.
But after several Democratic amendments fell short, most again by party lines, the issue of accepting $2.5 billion federal dollars for Medicaid expansion drew the most debate. This after a Senate committee last month blocked the move by opting to study its impacts further.
Mr. President, this is simply the right thing to do. This is not the time to do more study, if that study means delay.
We're considering the gift of a baby elephant. Really cute when you get it. Slow, expensive, eats a lot, and there's a lot of waste when it grows up.
Again, by party lines, the Senate rejected a move to authorize expansion. And during a taping of Close Up airing this Sunday, Governor Hassan very gently expressed concern over cuts to HHS and put forth hope that Medicaid expansion could be revived.
I am very hopeful that we are going to find a way to include Medicaid expansion in the state's plans for the upcoming few months and years.
It is an issue that threatens to derail the budget process, but Senate President Peter Bragdon did leave the door open, albeit very slightly.
I think there are some very legitimate concerns the Republican senators have about the long-term impact. If we can get those questions answered and resolved, anything's possible, but I think the hurdle is pretty high.
All right, so the next step, select the members of the Democratic House and the Republican Senate will meet in that, everybody loves this one, the Committee of Conference. And with a roughly $350 million difference of opinion, it's fair to say there could be some long days and nights ahead in Concord this month and maybe even beyond. Reporting live, Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.